At the age of 37, Wendy Lawson woke up one morning unable to feel the left side of her body.
It was like somebody had just drawn a chalk line down the center of me and my whole left side was numb.
Wendy, a flight paramedic, thought initially she had just pinched a nerve, so she visited several chiropractors. Nothing seemed to help.
So 2 days later, that numbness had come over into my right side, and now I was starting to cripple up with spasms and tremors.
Paralyzed and scared, Wendy went to the hospital. Doctors began to run a battery of tests. Finally, an MRI revealed the problem: multiple sclerosis, an incurable and disabling disease that attacks the central nervous system.
I had 7 lesions in my brain, the main one in my brain stem. The doctor had come in and had told me that I had had a severe acute attack of MS and that I would probably never walk again.
For over a decade, Wendy struggled with the debilitating side effects of MS.
I could be in an exacerbation for weeks and months and then come out of it and be in remission for maybe a week or two, maybe 3 weeks, but then I would be right back into it. I just went on with that MS for 11 years, in and out of wheelchairs, hospitals, rehabs, my bed.
Wendy eventually started going to church for comfort. Through her suffering, Wendy's faith and love for God only grew.
A lot of my friends in church had seen me crippled up, laying in the pew to listen to the sermon because I couldn't sit up. I had a Bible study at my house. There were like 6 older women that would come over and pull their chairs around my bed as I laid there all crippled and taught me the healing word of God and taught me about Jesus.
In 1997, 11 years after her diagnosis, Wendy prayed that she would be in remission long enough to go on an international trip with her church. That April, she was healthy enough to travel and joined a group for a healing crusade in Madagascar.
We were in a field, I'll never forget it, a big field out of red dirt in the middle of nowhere. These people had walked for miles, most without shoes.
Thousands came for prayer. Wendy prayed for a small boy with a broken leg. When she prayed, something happened to Wendy that she never expected.
My hands were still kind of crippled, and I bent down and put my hands around his broken tibia, and the only prayer I said was, "God, please heal this little boy in Jesus' name." That was it. I felt that bone go back in place. My hands were on fire. They were tingling. Tears started to well up in my eyes. He let go of his friend's arms, jumped up and down, screaming, "Alleluia, alleluia." But at that same time, God had laid on my heart, in my spirit, "You're healed, Wendy." So I just accepted that.
Wendy believed that God had spoken to her. So she decided on the flight home to stop taking all of her medicine.
After that whole crusade, I knew something had happened to me. I just thanked him day and night for my healing, even though I didn't feel it yet. You know, I just kept thanking him.
Over the next few months, Wendy slowly started to feel better. After 6 months, she visited her doctor for a remarkable checkup.
And he said, "I know this wasn't modern medicine." He said, It was a miracle, dramatic and remarkable recovery. And I said, "I call it Dr. Jesus." 6 months later, I was out riding my motorcycle again. I was skydiving. I was doing everything that I used to do 11 years before that.
After her healing, Wendy had a strong desire to go on more medical mission trips. She soon got a stunning phone call.
The Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, just a couple months after that, had called me and told me that my medical license had been reinstated by a grandfather clause back in 1975. So God always knew I wanted to be a doctor, a dentist, so now I was going to be able to do all these things overseas. So God just answered my heart's desire.
Since her healing in 1997, Wendy's MS has been a distant memory. She has traveled to over 37 countries on healthcare and disaster relief trips, and she works in full-time ministry. She's recorded her healing journey in a book called God's Madcap Missionary.
He's done everything for me. He has brought me where I could never have gone on my own. I just shout my testimony from the rooftops because I want everybody to know that it's not impossible. Just keep your faith in God.